Hello everyone, my name is Joy Cope and I am doing a presentation on the history of Valentine's Day. I decided to choose this topic just because, you know, hey, it's Valentine's Day. So, here we go. So, there's not much about this holiday that is pure fact. A lot of it is actually just assumptions and myths and theories and other legends, and so I'll talk about a bunch of different legends that are told about this holiday. But the crazy thing about this is that approximately 150 million Valentine's Day cards are exchanged annually, which does make Valentine's Day the second most popular card-sending holiday. Christmas is the first, and so it's kind of crazy to think that after Christmas we choose Valentine's Day to give cards. Not much is known about this holiday, but I'm going to just tell you what is told or what people think. And that's a picture of Valentine or Valentinus to the side there, and we'll learn about him now. So the first legend talks about Valentine freeing the Christians from the Roman prisons. And as you can see from the top two pictures, the top one is where Peter and Paul were imprisoned back in the Roman prison, and then the bottom one's just another picture of a prison. And it was told that Valentine was martyred for helping Christians escape these prisons, and all the Valentines that I'll talk about in the legends, they were all martyrs. But it was said that once he was imprisoned, he fell in love with Jailer's daughter, who went to visit him while he was in the prison. And before he died, he wrote a letter to her, and it ended instead of sincerely saying, "From your Valentine." And that's where we get our endings for our Valentine's cards that we use today. So the second legend is that Valentine was a preacher. And it says that in the early 3rd century Rome, there was an emperor, and he did think that single men were more successful in war than the married and the men with families, and so he outlawed marriage. And Valentine thought that that was wrong and decided to perform secret marriages, and that's what the picture is of on the side right there. He's performing a secret marriage between those two people, and once he was found out, he was put to death by the emperor. And so, just another martyr. There are a bunch of other interesting facts that I found, but some people state that the Valentine's Day was marked February 14th because of the birds' mating seasons. So it just depends on what people believe, really. There's no actual hard facts about it. The only hard facts I do have are statistics stating that there's today about 1 billion cards, that we send each year to people during Valentine's Day, and that's, a statistic by the Greeting Card Association. I also have other statistics stating that Esther A. Holland was pretty much the mother of Valentine's, and she was a great woman who made Valentine's cards, and that's where it all kind of started, was her mass producing Valentine's cards for people, and that just became a stock thing that people did for Valentine's Day. So then there's just a picture of some birds for the February 14th mating season of Valentine's Day. So who truly was the greatest at Valentine's Day? And some might say Shakespeare, because he wrote Romeo and Juliet, but the oldest Valentine's poem known today is a poem written by Charles, Duke of Orleans, to his wife. He wrote this after he was imprisoned up in a tower after the Battle of Agincourt. And here's a picture below of his letter, which is illegible, but there it is. And that's where the oldest poem. So today our traditions kind of vary. We've adopted sub holidays underneath this holiday, and people all around the world show their love to their family members and friends in different ways. More recently, there's been a sub-holiday, such as Gallen's Day, where women celebrate the love they have for their women friends and other important women in their life. And this is still shown through cards and chocolates and candies and gifts and such like that. Others celebrate Single Awareness Day and other similar titled names where singles will gift themselves Valentine's or do nothing in protest of this card holiday. And either way, it's all, everyone experiences the 14th of February. And so that's kind of just a little history about Valentine's Day. So I hope you all have an amazing Valentine's Day, however you wish to celebrate it. Thank you.